If you're waking up multiple times throughout the night, or you sleep through the night and you don't feel rested when you wake up, more than likely you're suffering from a condition called nocturnal hypoglycemia, which is essentially where your blood sugar is crashing throughout the night and you are having a surge of adrenaline that causes you to wake up, feel rested, and feel anxious. This is Dr. Daniel Torres, and in this video, I want to teach you how exactly you can correct the number one cause of insomnia. But first, if you haven't already, be sure that you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell to be notified of future videos. If you want to sleep great, the secret is you have to have a very stable blood sugar. If your blood sugar is all over the place, if it's too high or too low, you will never sleep soundly through the night. So if we look at blood sugar stability, there is a hormone called cortisol. Cortisol is the stress hormone, meaning it is released whenever you have an internal or an external stress. It can be emotional, psychological. It can also be a physical stress like exercise. The other function cortisol has is it keeps your blood sugar stable when your blood sugar goes down. So the way it works is it all starts in your brain with the hormone release of ACTH. ACTH will go from your brain, it will travel to the adrenal glands that sit on top of your kidneys. Cortisol will then travel over to the liver and tell the liver to take out stored sugar called glycogen and dump some of it in your bloodstream, so then your blood sugar comes back up. Now, really important, you want blood sugar to be right in the middle. You do not want it to be too high or too low. So here's the thing, the adrenal glands that produce your cortisol can become exhausted, just like if you overworked a muscle group. So if your stress load exceeds your capacity to produce cortisol on a day-to-day basis, combined with your blood sugar crashing from eating a lot of sugary foods, or if you skip meals all the time, or just generally don't eat enough, this will work your adrenals to the max. They will start to exhaust and the neurocoordination will start to become discoordinated. How does this relate to you not being able to sleep soundly through the night? Well, when you go to sleep at night, your blood sugar is gradually going down through the night. So if you've already depleted your cortisol reserves because your stress load has really exceeded your capacity to produce enough cortisol, combined with your blood sugar crashing throughout the day, your glycogen reserves are gonna be down. Then at 2 or 3 in the morning, when your blood sugar drops low enough, you're gonna start needing another hormone to help raise your blood sugar. The hormone is epinephrine, the fight and flight adrenaline hormones. This is where your heart rate increases, your blood pressure increases. You're gonna feel anxious because adrenaline's gonna be pumping through your body. You definitely will not be able to sleep. You will wake up, or I guess I should say, if you are sleeping, it will not be in deep restorative phases. So if you want to be able to sleep soundly through the night, the number one thing you're going to want to do is stabilize your blood sugar. Here are my top 7 dietary and lifestyle interventions to stabilize your blood sugar so that you can start sleeping soundly throughout the night. Now, up to this point, this has been general recommendations. This is nowhere nearly as effective as you have customized care from a qualified physician. That is why I always recommend working with a qualified practitioner, such as myself or other doctors at our Red River facilities. Or you can also schedule a free consultation. We work with individuals all over the country. If you found value in this video, give it a thumbs up, give it a like, share it with your friends and family. Otherwise, stay tuned.